Welcome to another episode of Millennial Investing Explained. Here's today's question. I know you have an interesting opinion on picking individual stocks in the market. Talk to us about that.
When you look at the compound annual growth rate of the S&P 500, beginning of 1928 or October 1928, up until about 2016, 2017, I'm talking about a high before the market, and then 2016, which is also a moderate peak. We can argue about the long-term, the CAGR all day long, pick your own number, but let's say it's 10%, right? If I'm going to be picking stocks, which involves work and research and diligence and timing and all these other types of things, I need to earn a better than 10% compound annual growth rate for that to be worthwhile. And doing that is a very difficult endeavor. Most people are not very good at that. And if you are good at that, you're likely going to be managing a large pile of other people's money, that alpha, that excess return in excess of the S&P 500's return by 2 or 3%. So that's what you're talking about, and operating a big fund and producing that kind of alpha, and people will pay you very well to do that. I believe that there's two reasons why this is not a good tactic for an investor with less than 100 grand in liquidity that's invested in the market, really less than a million. The alpha is very difficult to produce. It's very difficult to actually outperform the index, and it's not guaranteed. Even if you do produce that alpha, even if you are able to get a 12% return on 100 grand instead of a 10% return, the amount of time you're putting into it, 2% is going to be 2 grand. That might equate to $10 or $12 an hour, and you can probably generate wealth far more efficiently doing something else.
Intuitively, that makes a lot of sense, and I hadn't necessarily thought of it that way myself until I read your book, because I've always been an individual stock picker since I started investing in the markets. We talk about picking individual stocks a lot here on the show, and of course, I think it's a great way to do it if you enjoy it, but I always enjoy hearing and learning the other side of the argument. Just because I like picking individual stocks, that doesn't mean it's the best solution for everyone listening. Some listeners may be better off or enjoy taking your strategy, Scott. I recommend people think about it objectively and decide what is really best for them. Maybe someone listening to the show today doesn't want to invest their money in the market at all, whether it be with your strategy or mine. It's certainly possible for someone to take that money that they were going to invest in the market and invest it in creating a passive income producing asset that they can own or benefit from for years and years to come. That's all for this episode of Millennial Investing Explained. Be sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, or subscribe to our YouTube channel to get even more free content.